And welcome, everybody. The time is nigh. Here we are for the World Cup of Pokemon VGC, hosted by none other than Victory Road. Bom dia to everybody. I am Costa, aka Quality, joined by the ever so lovely Mr. Jamie Boyt. How are we doing, Jamie? Are we excited?
Excellent. Very excited. This is going to be the largest World Cup that we've ever had. We've got 55 countries competing for that title. Going to be an absolutely massive tournament and going to be some absolutely amazing play coming out of it.
It really will be, because this is the single most biggest team tournament ever organized by, I'd say officially, but of course unofficially, grassroots organizations. And also, we are sponsored, Victory Road is sponsored by Elgato. I feel like that's a first when it comes to VGC, so we are absolutely thrilled to have all of you lovely people at home here tuning in with us, and all of the teams, all of the managers, so much work put into this. Huge shout outs to Victory Road, but I'm really looking forward to it. And of course, I'm here with the UK manager, and they've got a very interesting match this weekend, but let's just see how that goes as well. But anyways, what we are going to be doing is going ahead straight to check out the schedule so we can see who is playing today.
Yeah, so we're going to be bringing you four matches today. We're going to be starting off with Denmark versus Sweden there, with Michelle Sorensen versus Pontus Westerlund. And we're going to have Puerto Rico versus Panama, with Kenneth De Jesus versus Gabriel Cedeño.
And then we are going to have the third match between Gabriel Gomez versus Alfonso Valenzuela, which they are going to be Venezuela versus Bolivia. And we're going to round it off with Kobe Weiss versus Diego Henriquez, Israel versus Portugal. But what we're going to do is go straight into actually seeing the standings that are currently available on the website between Denmark and Sweden. And as we can see here, ladies and gents, Kim has already played up against Alexander. Alexander was the victor there, 2-0 win. And then we do have Frederick Jan versus Albin, where Frederick was able to go ahead and win. And funnily enough, is that not a Calyrex? Oh my lord, I forgot its name because I don't use it anymore.
It's two of them.
Exactly, no, that wins.
Ice Riders coming out from both teams here, and both being able to get the victory over that Ho and the Kyogre as well. So one apiece for Denmark and Sweden. So whoever is going to be able to win this match between Michelle and Pontus is going to take the lead for their respective country here.
Exactly. So what we're going to do is, ladies and gents, these are pre-recorded videos. We're going to pop straight into the player profiles so we could get the videos and the matches underway. We've got Michelle Sorensen coming up first, representing Denmark with their lovely, lovely flag on the top left there, rocking the Xerneas, Suicune, Rillaboom, Metagross, Tyranitar, and the Landorus Incarnate.
Yeah, and we're bringing back the Xerneas, finally. It's been away, even in Series 8, we didn't see too many Xerneas, but it is finally back. I am one of the people who is absolutely thrilled it is. I'm sure there are a lot of people that are completely the opposite of opinion to me, but it's going to be great to see this Xerneas coming out here, and I believe from the other team as well.
And let's find out, shall we, as we are going to be going on to Pontus's player profile. And like you correctly did point out, Jamie, we've got another Xerneas, Xerneas versus Xerneas. So on Pontus's side, though, he's going to be rocking with the Incineroar partnered up to it, Rillaboom, Urshifu, Rapid Strike, Volcarona, and female Indeedee.
Yes, going really in with that redirection for the Xerneas. You do want to be getting that Geomancy up with the Xerneas. So got two redirection Pokemon with that Volcarona and Indeedee coming out from Pontus' side. And then the tried and true core of that Incineroar, Rillaboom, and Urshifu. So going to be some very solid Pokemon coming out from Pontus' side. Some interesting picks coming out from Michelle as well. But I'm just really excited to finally see a Xerneas versus Xerneas after quite a few years of it just being on the sidelines.
Exactly, and we no longer have Dynamax, ladies and gents, which means you are in for a treat of strategic positioning, and we're going to go ahead and transition straight into the match. Ladies and gents, your first one of the day, the premiere of the World Cup hosted by Victory Road, and both players are now going to go ahead select their Pokemon. How are we feeling about this matchup in general, Jamie? Do you feel like one of the two trainers has a very big advantage against the other?
A big advantage is usually a steel type when you're facing down an opposing Xerneas. Pontus doesn't have access to that. Going to have to be relying on his Xerneas and maybe his Volcarona as well to be able to resist the Xerneas coming out from Michelle's side of the field. But Metagross is going to be a very good answer to that Xerneas. Can't be intimidated by the Incineroar as well, so just has to really watch out for the opposing Volcarona and the Incineroar there. But yeah, we're going to be jumping straight into this match. We're going to have to see which player is able to get their Xerneas into position, whether they're able to get those Geomancies up to start sweeping, which we haven't seen for a while now.
Exactly. Or if they plan on bringing Xerneas somehow in the back, potentially, in order to try to sweep, which has been an alternate strategy that trainers have been recently trying to opt for, as we are to be seeing Pontus lead with that Rillaboom, Urshifu for Rapid Strike, and Michelle's going to be leading with her shiny Xerneas and her own Rillaboom.
And key here, it looks like Pontus' Rillaboom is going to be setting that Grassy Surge, so most likely going to be faster and would likely have access to a faster fake out. So Pontus really has the choice of where he wants a fake out to land if that's the move that he wants to go for. Michelle does threaten down that opposing Urshifu with the Rillaboom on her side of the field as well, and can still go for those fake outs into the Urshifu as well. You could be seeing the trading of fake outs here. You could be seeing that awkward play of if the Rillaboom wants to stop the opposing Rillaboom from attacking the opposing Pokemon, then you can fake them out, but it's the Urshifu's going to be scared here from the Rillaboom. Going to be switching out into that Volcarona.
Ooh, and if there's any sort of physical move coming up from the Rillaboom onto that Volcarona slot, there's a chance for it to get burnt, as the Rillaboom on Pontus' side is going to go ahead and flinch the Xerneas, whilst the Rillaboom on Michelle's side doesn't out to go for the Urshifu slot. Just completely ignores it, hopes to try to beat a speed tie there, but it's not able to do so, but I guess it will get a bit of chip damage onto it.
And that ends up working out slightly in their favor as well, because if you would land that fake out into the Volcarona, there is always that chance of getting that Flame Body activation to burn the Rillaboom and really cut its damage output in half. So actually quite a nice target there for the fake out ending up being into Rillaboom. Going to be switching out the Rillaboom on Michelle's side of the field into that Suicune to threaten down the Volcarona and get that fake out pressure back onto the field.
Oh, but we're going to be seeing the Volcarona on Pontus' side go for the Quiver Dance. It's got plus one in special attack, special defense, and speed, which means, yes, it is starting to be a threat. But, Jamie, talking about threats, we see the good old-fashioned Geomancy, powered by the Power Herb, being able to give itself plus two of the exact same boosts.
It's effectively the same as the Quiver Dance that Volcarona went for, but just twice as fast and twice as effective thanks to that Power Herb.
Exactly, as we're going to be seeing the Rillaboom go for the Drum Beating. Wow, its signature move that it did get, of course, introduced in this generation. Deals so much damage onto the Xerneas, but more importantly, it's going to be able to drop its speed now from plus two to plus one stat stages.
Did see the Volcarona go for the Quiver Dance before the Geomancy of the Xerneas, so both the Xerneas and the Volcarona will be sitting at plus one stages of speed here. So if the Volcarona is going to be faster, it's still going to be able to move first before that Xerneas. So actually quite a crucial drum beating coming out there to reduce the speed, and now followed up by a Grass Glide.
Oh my lord, that was so much damage. Doesn't pick up the KO, which might hint that it is not a item boosting the grass type moves there, as we do see the Citrus Berry recovery from the Suicune, and a Struggle Bug from the Volcarona will be able to drop the Suicune's special attack to minus one, whilst being able to push that Xerneas to plus one now, as the Moonblast comes out, and due to that Struggle Bug, just showing why the speed stats there were so, so crucial interactions, it's not going to be able to pick up a KO, as the Snarl will be bringing the Volcarona back down to neutral of its special attack.
So it seems like both players have the same idea here. Set up with one of their Pokemon, but then also reduce the special attack back down so then they're not going to be as threatening in these coming turns. But we saw how much that Grassy Glide did in Coon. Easily going to be in range of another one. And of course, that Grassy Glide getting that priority thanks to the grassy terrain. Going to be moving first, even before the Volcarona and the Xerneas, even though they've got their plus speed boosts. So interesting decision to run both the Drum Beating and the Grassy Glide here so that you can get that speed drop and then also still have access to that priority attack with the Rillaboom as well. But the Struggle Bug and the Quiver Dance really, really doubling down on stopping any special damage coming out from the opposing side of the field. And that is exactly what you want when you are facing down a Xerneas.
Exactly. You want to try to mitigate as much of its damage output as possible, as the Xerneas is not going to be scared of this situation, goes for the Protect, as the Grassy Glide actually opts to go and does connect with that Protect. And the Volcarona, on the other hand, just being able to go ahead and put on so much pressure, both with chip damage, but more importantly as well, the special attack that now has been dropped down to minus two of the Suicune, but Suicune doesn't matter. Doesn't care right now, should I say, as it goes for a Tailwind, actually.
Yeah, so now the Xerneas should be moving first before the opposing Volcarona, so going to be able to attack before any more of those Struggle Bugs would be able to come out from the Volcarona here, but quite a nice protect there from the Xerneas. The Suicune managing to get out that Tailwind in the face of that Grassy Glide, which of course doesn't care about the Tailwind, it still will be able to out-prioritize everything and attack first with the Rillaboom. So the Suicune is still definitely going to be threatened down by that Grassy Glide, but really nice to be able to put their Xerneas faster than that Volcarona, even without having to go for that Geomancy. The Volcarona can still match that with a Quiver Dance, but the Tailwind is a really nice position for Michelle.
Oh, but the Suicune does not want to get taken down just yet. It switches out for the Rillaboom. Rillaboom on Ponce's side completely ignores it. Goes for the Xerneas. Isn't quite enough to pick up a KO there, but the Moonblast from Xerneas comes out. Oh, it will actually, of course, oh my lord, land a critical hit. Nearly pick up the KO onto a Pokemon that resists Fairy-type moves. And the Volcarona is going to be revealing a Citrus Berry, being able to recover that tiny bit more, but no, Rillaboom does not like that damage. Might be an indication of an Assault Vest variant on Michelle's side there, as it wasn't actually able to take that much damage from a neutral, super effective type move.
Quite a nice pivot in for Michelle here, getting that Rillaboom back onto the field, going to have access to that Fake Out as well, and being able to crit straight through that Special Defense boost and those Struggle Bugs as well, to be able to do a huge amount of damage to that Volcarona. Going to be doing a lot of damage to the Volcarona, putting it quite low here, probably still not in range of another attack. You'd probably need another critical hit coming up from the Xerneas, and the Rillaboom can't really threaten down Volcarona either, so even though it did get that critical hit to have to recover with that Citrus Berry, still going to be in a very nice position here. You're losing turns of the Tailwind here. If you're going to be going for that Fake Out or even the Grassy Glide, that didn't really care about the Tailwind anyway, so going to be taking away the turns of the Tailwind here. Maybe the Volcarona wants to protect so that it can stall out some of those turns. The Xerneas is still going to be in range of another one of those Grassy Glides now from the Rillaboom. Also, you'd have to go for a Fake Out if you're Michelle onto the Rillaboom to stop the Xerneas from being KO'd this turn, but then you're leaving that Volcarona free to either set up another Quiver Dance or just go for those Struggle Bugs once again to reduce the special attack of the Xerneas. Even going on the offensive if it has a fire move could possibly be in range with the Xerneas now.
As the Moonblast is going to be coming out, as of course it will not be picking up any sort of KO, no critical hits landed again. It will be dropping the special attack though of that Volcarona to minus one, and we are going to be seeing the Fiery Dance coming out. Does land the crit of its own, picks up the KO onto the Xerneas. I don't see a special attack boost there, as it did have half a chance to be able to do so. Grassy Glide though goes into the Volcarona, isn't quite enough to pick up the KO yet again, that double up, but the Rillaboom on Pontus' side goes for the U-turn. It will be getting that pivot going for Pontus' side, as he's been able to get rid of such a huge threat and bring his own onto the field now.
Yes, that Volcarona was in a really, really nice position there, facing down the Xerneas and the Rillaboom. Exactly the Pokemon you'd be facing down those two Pokemon, and getting that revenge crit against the Xerneas as well, being able to crit through those Geomancy boosts to get the knockouts. So very nice for the Volcarona here. It is now sitting in front of the Rillaboom still, and the grassy terrain has now disappeared, so there will be no more Grassy Glide priority coming out from the Rillaboom. It has been on this field one turn, so there's no Fake Out potential that could stop the Xerneas from going for a Geomancy here, so gonna have to probably try and get that Rillaboom off the field so it can come back onto the field, get those Fake Outs going to stop the Xerneas, because it's almost certainly going to be clicking that Geomancy here. And the Volcarona still has the Quiver Dance speed boost at least, so would be able to most likely outspeed the Suicune and the Rillaboom. Probably not pick up the knockout on this Suicune, just Struggle Bug and Fiery Dance, so this weekend may want to be able to go for that Snarl. Might be in range with the Volcarona of the Snarl as well, but Volcarona is just going to be going for that Fiery Dance here, probably picking up the knockout on that Rillaboom.
And it does. And it also gets a special attack boost, now being able to bring itself back up to neutral, so it could go ahead and deal some much better damage output, but it's not going to be able to, as the Skull comes out from the Suicune and does pick up a K onto it. But Pontus' Xerneas is now so free to go for that Geomancy and get plus two stages all around.
So going to be in a really nice position for Pontus here. You've taken care of the Xerneas on Michelle's side of the field, and now you don't have to worry about that anymore. You'd only have to worry about a potential Metagross in the back. That would be Michelle's best answer to this Xerneas now, especially now that the Volcarona has been taken care of by that Suicune. The Tailwind did peter out there, so you're going to definitely be slower than this Xerneas here, and we'll have to see if that's going to... It's going to be the Rillaboom for Pontus' side of the field, so going to have access to Fake Out if that Metagross is going to be coming out for Michelle's side, and it looks like that's exactly what's happening here. So Pontus is in a really nice position to be able to just go for a Fake Out into the Metagross, put a stop to that, and now with the Geomancy boost, there's no Tailwind on Suicune's side of the field. It's definitely going to be in range of either a Dazzling Gleam or a Moonblast at this point, so really, really nice positioning for Pontus here. Michelle's down to their last two Pokemon, and Pontus still has a Pokemon waiting in the back as well, so it's looking like a really, really solid position for Pontus here. Even though the Metagross is facing down that Xerneas, it can't do anything this turn thanks to the Fake Out.
Yeah, as the Xerneas will be going for the Dazzling Gleam, picks up the KO onto the Suicune. It is going down out of this game one. Metagross is flinched from that Fake Out. So like you said, Pontus was able to go ahead and benefit quite well with the positioning gameplay that he was able to go ahead and put out against Michelle's Pokemon. Even though Metagross is such a lovely pick to go up against Xerneas and Rillaboom, it's not up against a boosted Xerneas, as well as all of the offensive pressure that Pontus had, even in the back as well.
Yeah, you can see the value of leaving your Xerneas Geomancy until the end there, because Pontus was able to take out Michelle's Xerneas before the Xerneas of his own even hit the field. So
yeah,
really nice saving the Xerneas in the back. Volcarona putting in a lot of work there. There was only really the Suicune on Michelle's side of the field that could deal with it, especially with the Metagross in the back. Maybe having access to a rock move. We didn't see the Metagross go for anything there. But Rillaboom and Xerneas don't really want to be facing down Volcarona at all. So Volcarona putting in a lot of work there. Even though it got that critical hit, doing so much damage through the Quiver Dance boost as well. May have been able to just take the game on its own if that didn't happen, but able to get the revenge crit on the Xerneas to be able to take that out as well. So Volcarona's a really key player for Pontus here. Michelle's going to have to find a way to break it. And Suicune is not really the best answer because of Quiver Dance just boosting your special defense. Scald's not going to do too much.
Do you think that Metagross would have been in a better position to actually bring it out earlier? But then again, I would assume that the Volcarona had to get KO'd over on Pontus' side for Michelle to be able to do that.
Yeah, you want your Metagross to be facing down the Xerneas, not particularly the rest of the Pokemon, because usually your partners to the Xerneas are going to be Pokemon that can deal with those steel types. So Metagross does want to be facing down the Xerneas and didn't really have the opportunity to. By the time that it hit the field, it was pretty much already in Pontus' favor, so does need to be dealing with that Volcarona. You do have the Tyranitar on that field. That is a very strong answer to that Volcarona, but do you want to be bringing Tyranitar in the face of Xerneas and the Rillaboom and the Urshifu as well? So it's going to be quite an awkward pick. Whether you have a rock move on the Landorus as well, if you do, that's going to be a very strong answer to that Volcarona as well. But even if it doesn't, it's Earth Power. Now that we shifted to Landorus Incarnate a lot more than the Landorus Therium form, going to be getting that sheer force boost on the Earth Power still does a huge amount of damage. And does naturally outspeed the Volcarona as well, so it could potentially get that Earth Power onto the Volcarona before it goes for the Quiver Dance as well, doing a lot of damage. But Michelle really needs to find a much better answer to Volcarona than just get a critical hit with Xerneas.
Yeah, and Landorus Incarnate, they do tend to either run as a third move slot, or should I say fourth one in this case, either substitute or some sort of rock type move, whether that's Stone Edge or Rock Slide. It might, if Michelle does have one of those moves, might really bring out fruition to her game plan, trying to push this to a game three, as we do see Pontus going ahead, leading with Rillaboom, Volcarona versus Michelle's Rillaboom of their own, and Suicune.
So Pontus, recognizing how good Volcarona was in that previous game, just going to be looking to set it up straight away here. We got the opposing Rillabooms facing down each other again, so we'll have to see where the fake outs go, if there's going to be any fake outs this turn. Faking out the Suicune wouldn't particularly work because it does have access to that inner focus ability. So really Pontus would only have going for the fake out into that Rillaboom, and then you could potentially get that Quiver Dance going up as well. But it looks like the Rillaboom on Michelle's side of the field is going first with that fake out, and that is one of the downsides of faking out the Volcarona.
No, that really is. That doesn't have the highest of chances to happen, but it's a chance nevertheless, as Drum Beating comes out, nearly picks up the KO onto the Suicune, does drop its speed to minus one, procs the citrus berry recovery, as it will be getting residual recovery over time thanks to that grassy terrain. But more importantly for Michelle's side, they're going to be going ahead and getting that tailwind up and going.
You can see one of the slight downsides of running drum beating over Woodhammer as your extra grass coverage move. Woodhammer would have easily picked up the knockout on that Suicune, whereas drum beating does have some really nice speed control with that speed drop. Maybe not enough to match the tailwinds that the Suicune can set up, but it's not quite strong enough to be able to take out that Suicune. And now we're going to have to see how the opposing Pokemon are trained, whether that Suicune can get a Scald into the Volcarona first to be able to do some damage before the Quiverdance. But even then, it's threatened down by the Grassy Glide from this Rillaboom to not even care about the tailwind at all.
And that's exactly what happens. Suicune unfortunately does go down, but will be bringing a free slot the next turn for Michelle side of the field, so they could try to go ahead and maybe try to counter Pontus's game plan. But Pontus goes for the knockoff. No berry anymore on the Volcarona, but guess what, it's got a Quiver Dance up. It is plus one in special attack, special defense, and that speed.
Yeah, so doing a little bit more damage than you technically do with the knockoff. You do 25% extra damage getting rid of that berry. So still quite a nice move coming out from the Rillaboom. And we're going to have to see if Michelle has an answer to that Volcarona. It is going to be a Landorus coming in here. So definitely an adjustment that needs to happen to be able to take care of that Volcarona. We'll have to see if the Landorus is going to be carrying that rock type move. With the Tailwind, it's going to be outspeeding the Volcarona even after it Quiver Dance. So if it is carrying that rock move, whether it's the rock slide or the stone edge, it will be able to knock out that Volcarona. If it's not carrying that, it's going to be a bit more awkward facing down the Quiver Dance of the Volcarona. Yep. May not be able to pick up the knockout on that anymore thanks to that special defense boost. So it's really going to be key here whether that Landorus is going to be able to land a rock move into that Volcarona. If not, it's going to be very close as well. It's still going to be open to that Rillaboom as well. It can go for the drum beating to try and put it slower than the Volcarona. If you have Protect on the Volcarona, you could probably Protect and go for a Drum Beating to try and match the Tailwind somewhat. But Volcarona not even planning on staying in here, switching straight into that Urshifu.
What a hard switch. Not what you would have expected in this scenario. Really fearing and respecting the Rock-type potential coverage on Landorus as the Grassy Glide comes out, deals more than half of Landorus's HP, whilst it's going to be able to retaliate with a Sludge Bomb, doing the exact same. And the knockoff, unfortunately, is not going to be enough thanks to that burn from turn one of Volcarona's Flame Body. Quite unfortunate, and it does reveal through that interaction that the Rillaboom on Pontus' side was indeed carrying the Assault Vest.
So a very nice play coming out from Michelle there. Pontus definitely respecting the potential rock move coming out from Landorus, but Michelle reading straight into that, getting some nice damage onto that Rillaboom. And the nice thing about this play as well is you still don't reveal whether you have a rock move or not, because that was just a prediction of the Volcarona either protecting or switching out there. So going to be able to preserve that information. And Urshifu is still going to be threatened down by that burn Rillaboom.
Ooh, as we're going to be seeing another pivot now, hard switch, should I say, from the Urshifu to the Volcarona. Oh, well played from Pontus there. It's going to be taking that Grassy Glide, retaliating with a Grassy Glide of its own, picking up a KO, critical hit, but the critical hit, of course, does not matter from that range. Michelle, unfortunately, does not have an Intimidate user, such as an Incineroar, to be able to try to get that damage output to drop from Pontus's Rillaboom, because it's just been going absolutely wild during this set.
That's one of the nice things about Grassy Glide. You don't care about Tailwind at all. You're going to be able to out-prioritize everything with the Grassy Glide in the grassy terrain. And Xerneas is going to be able to come out here. It will be able to get his Geomancy up somewhat freely, but we'll be open to the drum beating or the Grassy Glide that can come out from the opposing Rillaboom. The Volcarona can still go for a Struggle Bug to be able to reduce its special attack down, so that when Pontus brings in, you would assume he has the Xerneas in the back, you would be able to reduce the special attack down of the Xerneas. You don't really care about this burn Rillaboom anymore. Not going to be able to do too much damage. The Grassy Glide you saw there just doing no damage into the Volcarona, probably healing more than with the Grassy Terrain Recovery than the Grassy Glide even did.
As we are going to be seeing the Grass Glide coming out from Michelle's Rillaboom into the opponent's Rillaboom, not being able to pick up any sort of KO there. Struggle Bug comes out, will be dropping the Xerneas' special attack down to minus one. Of course, it does not matter on Rillaboom as it is a physical attacker, as the Xerneas will be going for the Geomancy, like you did mention, Jamie. And I feel like that drum beating is just going to be coming out from Pontus' Rillaboom right now. Nothing's going to stop it. It's going to get that damage off and bring it down to plus one of its speed. But most notably, we didn't see the Volcarona even try to go for a Quiver Dance of its own. It just wants to go for the damage mitigation, as the Rillaboom does go for that drum beating like we did mention, and just deals so much damage onto a Xerneas that looks like it could actually be quite bulky.
Yeah, that took that pretty well, so would be able to take another one coming out there. But yeah, the speed drop on the Xerneas going to come into play. If the Xerneas on Ponce's side ever gets out, that Geomancy will definitely be faster. And the Volcarona being able to get that Struggle Bug down onto the Xerneas means it probably won't even be able to pick up the knockout on the Volcarona turn, which would mean another Struggle Bug would be coming this Volcarona's, this Xerneas's way from that Volcarona. So it's looking really rough for Michelle. They lost their answer to the Volcarona in that Landorus pretty early on, so still no real way of breaking through that Volcarona. The Suicune got KO'd really easily as well to Rillaboom. Even just focusing down on the Volcarona, there hasn't really been an answer to the Rillaboom side of the field.
It hasn't, as the Dazzling Gleam is going to be picking up the KO onto the Rillaboom. Of course, that will be giving Pontus that free switch in the following turn. Volcarona goes for the Fiery Dance, connects into the Rillaboom, and picks up the KO. Maybe potentially trying to fish for a special attack boost whilst it can, but at this point, I don't think Xerneas can bring this back. Even though, if you wanted a Pokemon to try to bring a game back for you when it's just the sole one left available on your field, it would be Xerneas, but I'm not sure. I think this is just a bit too tough, isn't it?
Yeah, most likely. The Volcarona still probably going to be able to survive whatever the Xerneas would throw at it. Going to be able to get off another one of those Struggle Bugs. No Protects coming out from the Urshifu either. Going to be eating that Moonblast and is going to be holding that Focus Sash, which is actually somewhat rare now going into this Series 10. So able to get off the Surging Strikes and will be able to just finish off this game. As even though it seems like the Xerneas is going to be pretty bulky, it's going to have to take this Struggle Bug and it's going to have to take the Surging Strikes as well. And even if it is able to survive here, an Aqua Jet is most likely going to follow up into the Xerneas to pick up that KO. So thanks to that Focus Sash, the Urshifu is going to be able to do a lot of damage to the Xerneas, maybe not even reveal the Xerneas on Pontus' side of the field, but it looks like that Surging Strikes is going to be enough to take this game for Pontus and for Sweep.
Well played. Congratulations to Pontus. Commiserations to Michelle. Pontus now, of course, will be pushing his team forward 2-1 from the current scores between the two countries. As that's very good, very positive play from Pontus. I did really like how Michelle was playing. I just felt like at some point they were a bit one step behind, essentially, from resource management in comparison to Pontus there. As, like you did point out, Jamie, the Volcarona was just so vital. And we did see that proc onto the Rillaboom, the Flame Body, being able to burn it, which has around like less than 50% chance to actually get it. So, very beneficial matchup in a way. Do you feel like it would be really nice if there was a rock type move on the Landorus on Michelle's side?
Even if there was, Pontus switched out the Volcarona at that point, and then the Landorus got just KO'd to two Grassy Glides. It seemed like Michelle was trying. Michelle had to cover too much. If you've covered the Volcarona with something like the Tyranitar, even, or the Landorus as well, you leave yourself open to the Rillaboom, which we saw put in all the work in that game too, just getting those drum beatings and the Grassy Glides, doing a huge amount of damage, dealing with the Suicune, dealing with the Landorus, and then that frees up the Volcarona completely. So really, Michelle was kind of on the back foot with the Pokemon in the teams there. If you can deal with one Pokemon, if you can deal with the Volcarona, you've left yourself open to the Rillaboom. If you can deal with the Rillaboom, you've left yourself open to the Volcarona.
Yeah. I mean, it makes a lot of sense. And of course, what we're going to be doing is, ladies and gents, we're going to be going on immediately, I think, unless there is a break. I'm not sure. Short break, of course. We're going to do a very, very short break because all of these matches are pre-recorded. We are not live. I mean, Mr. Jamie and myself are live, but the matches themselves are not live. They are pre-recorded. So we'll be back very soon. So don't go anywhere, and we'll catch you in a bit.